1 mile northwest of the West Yorkshire model village of Saltaire, high on the northern slope of the Aire Valley, stands an overgrown woodland. Strewn amongst the dense undergrowth, elaborately carved stone remains litter the ground. Brushing aside the dead leaves and moss reveals delicate mosaic flooring. You can almost sense echoes of a bygone era, for these are the remains of the house once known as Milner Field. This was the grandest and most well-known of the homes built by the Salt Dynasty, whose renown and wealth was founded on the fortunes made by Sir Titus Salt, one of the greatest captains of the Victorian industrial era, and also one of its most ardent philanthropists. Sir Titus had purchased the site in 1869 on which stood the ancient Elizabethan house of Milner Field. Titus's youngest and most successful son, Titus Jr., commissioned architect Thomas Harris to design and build a grand new home in the current Gothic fashion. This no-expense-spared exercise was to be both a modern home with all the latest mod cons and a statement of wealth and power. For the next 18 years, the house would be at the very heart of West Yorkshire society, with Catherine Salt relishing her role as hostess at the Great House. The ultimate accolade was paid to the family with two royal visits in 1882 and 1887. Shortly after the last royal visit, the first of several shadows was to fall on the house, when Titus Jr. died suddenly at the early age of 44. Catherine found him in the snooker room, collapsed on the floor. A doctor was called, but by the time he arrived, Titus Jr. was dead, the victim of a weak heart. Like a cloak of night wrapping itself about the house and its occupants, the property began to gain a sinister reputation, as almost all of these families would suffer from earlier unusual deaths or oddly recurring bouts of ill luck. Salt's Mill, who still owned the house, wanted rid of this white elephant, but despite two auction attempts, the estate remained unsold. The house now began a sad decline into rack and ruin, its sole purpose a source of building materials for the mill. From the date of its building to the present, the house has been much photographed and written about. Local stories and rumours abound. Now, local authors Richard Lee Vandendal and David Beale tell the full story of this once magnificent house in their new publication, Milner Field, the lost country house of Titus Salt Jr. Bringing together a wealth of information following many years' research and input from local and national archives, along with family stories, images, and anecdotes from the Salt family, the history of this important Victorian estate is told in a fascinating and easily accessible way. This book will be launched at the Salt Air Festival 2011.